Hello everyone, Kevvl here once again. Let us count the remaining Mavericks. One Maverick, two Maverick, three Mavericks, four Mavericks,
To counteract the extremely long video we just had, this next one's gonna be pretty short. I need a breather, so we're fighting one of the easiest bosses, Dark Dizzy. If it's any indicator on how easy he is, just look at that mugshot. Does he look like a walrus, or is it just me? And we all know how walruses are, I mean, yeah, not gonna be hard. Despite being slightly harder than Grizzly Slash, he's still a mockery. 3 years ago, Sigma created him, but he escaped and went into hiding. Unfortunately, poor guy was so weak that Sigma forgot he existed. That's just insulting. He's named after Dizzy Reed. That's the stage name of the keyboardist from Guns N' Roses. For once, he actually has a cooler name in Japan, at least in my opinion. It is Dark Necrobat. His weapon, that he rarely uses, is the Darkhold, and he's got a fuel tank. This level has a bit of a design oversight, to say the least. Doesn't matter if you're on an emulator, a console, or the PC version like I am, that black hole graphic just always seems to give you slowdown. Might just be me, but I'm always at 42 frames per second in this area, which is kinda lame. Still, all it really does is speed up my reaction time, but eh, it's annoying. Most of this area is all about speed. The faster, the better. The constellations fire off Baton Bone B82, and little spikes, known as Stardust. They disappear after a short while. Stand on this platform, just in front of the Gunvolt. And then stand here. Did I say Gunvolt? I meant Spark Gunner. There's a difference? Oh well. Here you definitely want to stand on the right edge of the platform, and then turn to the left while firing at bats. As far over as possible is ideal. It'll give you just enough room to kill things. And again, we want to jump as far forward as possible and stand in the middle this time. Thankfully, this is a lot easier because they're all far away. And bats are easy to predict and manipulate. Duck here and you'll be safe. And if you want to scroll those bats off screen, go ahead. Subtank! Which I missed. Wait, no, I want you! Oh well, I'll get it later. You can just jump up and grab it, but I failed to do that for some reason. Watch this be the successful run. This here is a Pararoid Jumbo. They can't latch onto your head, but they can latch onto the ceiling, and fire little shots at you. They're not too much of a threat, but they have a lot of health. Couple snipers, nothing too bad. And whoops, I just respawned everything. Sometimes that happens. It's a good thing in cases if you want to reset, and it's a bad thing in others if you don't. Like right here, I definitely want to reset. Okay, made it through, okay. Here you want to reset just off the start to switch gravity around, because it makes this next area a bit easier to deal with. And moving forward. Couple snipers, but they aren't too much of a hassle, and everything else can't even catch up to you. And we're already on to Dark Dizzy. I almost said Grizzly Slash. No idea what that background is supposed to look like. Some sort of tanks, but why is that in an observatory? Hey look, it's Shade Man! And he squeaks. I've been waiting for you! Hey, can't you understand the urgency of our present situation? There's no time to fight! Who cares? I don't take orders from anyone! The word Sigma means nothing to me! X didn't say Sigma, so there must be some subconscious issues there. I'll destroy all Mavericks like you! Well, I'm always ready! Such simple dialogue. Oh well. Dark Dizzy loves to fly around the screen. He spends most of the match doing that. Occasionally he'll fire off bats at you, but oh come on. They're not a threat. They're just bats. And they like to fly off the screen on their own, rather than homing in on you relentlessly, which would make them a threat. Gotta perform some ducking and regular shot firing to destroy all the rapid-fire bats. Occasionally, he will lunge at you, and that may or may not happen here. If he manages to grab you, he'll do some damage and suck your health bar, which will go back into his. Whoa, there it is. It's got a pretty weird hitbox. His wings won't hurt you there. And yeah, this guy's easy. Bats are his main method of attack, and considering bats are the easiest enemies in the game, that's not a good thing for the poor guy. Once he hits about one-third health, he'll start using his desperation move, which is a big sonar thing. Remind you of anything? Yeah, it's basically the same as good old sonar shot from Shade Man. Then he'll use the Dark Hold, which will either fire off another sonar shot, or more bats. These things move slow, so they're not an issue. But to dodge the Dark Hold, you want to duck, and then dash towards him. You'll go underneath the bats, or underneath his sonar shot, if he decides to use that. And yeah, this guy's not an issue. He's almost dead. Ducking. Hanging. Sliding. Come on, Dark Dizzy. Take some more damage and die. No, wait. I want you dead. Okay, Dark Dizzy is down. Not a threat. Just laughable. Capcom just really got lazy there, made it exactly like Shade Man. We got the Dark Hold. It inverts colors in the screen for some reason, and stops time temporarily. It's basically the same as the Flash Stopper. Doesn't work on bosses, though. Charge it up, and it actually does not do anything. This weapon has no charged version. We also got the fuel tank and life up. He was a Maverick created by Sigma, yada yada, I already said that. And let's save. Oh, whoa, we've got something from cutscenes. I've been fighting the Sigma virus for a long time. It is the virus that causes all Reploids to transform into Mavericks. The most dreadful virus to ever exist. Why? I wonder why I'm not harmed. Instead, I feel energy growing within my body. What on earth is happening to me? I have a bad feeling about this. What am I fighting for? That's all the report on Zero. Zero has fought Sigma several times. I believe he has the virus antibodies. It's possible he doesn't react negatively to the virus. His power output is actually growing. For the most part, the body systems of X and Zero remain mysteries. I can't predict what will happen. I suggest you take measures. Keep this secret. I'll think it over. His power is growing with the virus. It's too dangerous to keep them loose. Please. At least do something about Zero, before it's too late, because apparently X is too good for all that. And now we have extras and outtakes. I gotta go back and get that sub-tank, the heart tank, and the capsule. Be back in a moment! Okay, let's get that sub-tank, without worrying about the stupid platform, because we have the Falcon armor. There it is. Let me get the E-tank now. Or the heart container. For the heart tank, you need gravity switched here. You see, there's a very small window of, well, that heart tank. You need to be very careful. Just kind of inch your way up. And grab it. Very close call there. But we're good and moving forward to the capsule. And here comes reason number two why you definitely want the Falcon armor. Switch to the Firefly laser, and you have to guide it into that little blue thing. Yeah. Prepare for, most likely, lots of failures. I'm probably just gonna speed this up, so see you when I get it. Finally! It's a good thing they give you spikes there. Okay. This is the program for the head part of the Gaia armor. Analyze and upload, yada yada. Once you upload all the four armors... He didn't tell us what it does. Cause good news, folks! It doesn't do anything. There's no special feature that the head part has. Yep, that's the Gaia armor for ya. Okay, moving on to the outtakes. Not including the ones where I failed against these spikes. Enjoy! Thankfully, it only cuts my frame rate by about 30- What the hell is your Stardust doing there? I'll blast you, I was moving too fast! What it does is increase my reaction speed. So I, did not see the spike there. Everything I said about reaction speed was an outright lie! It's known as Stardust. They are instant death, but they will disappear after a short while. Here, what you want to do is not that. Or that. Basically the same as the ones from... Oh, dear. That was close. Oh, no! Well, that was... That was just bound to happen. And yes, we have to wait for that platform. So, doing it again. What the... Oh, it exploded on me! You jerk! And there's a spike on that platform. Yeesh. That could have ended badly. For the bats. And you'll be clear. But make sure... Oh my goodness, what the hell? We had spikes on the platform! That's new. Because more bats. Come on now, bats, appear. Okay, moving forward. And be careful in case there's a spike on that platform. Do as I say, not as I do. Fire at as many bats as possible. Being a bat boss means there's plenty of... What the hell did I just do? Oh, silly mistakes. Gotta love them. Couple snipers here. Oh, and those dragonfly chameleon enemies are... Wow, I just died. Oh, whoa. Okay, I'm in a bad position. Let's reset it. Better to reset than to take a risk. Okay, and that was a sniper. Dang it. Like, right here. This level of terrain is a lot easier to get through. Whoa. Okay. Am I okay? No, I'm not. Blasted. I'm not sure what just happened. But it wasn't good. Couple bats. And here, you want to reset from the start, because it makes the terrain a lot easier to get through. Come on now. Oh, nope. Failure. Yeah? Whoa! What the... I am speechless. Oh, if this were a hard boss, I'd be extremely disappointed, but that was just funny. Oh boy.
Difficulty analysis time. Let us count the rating. One.
Breather boss, breather rating. No, seriously, this guy's a pushover. The only remotely difficult areas are in the stage, and once you know how to get through them, no issue. The only frustrating part about this was I had to go through that extremely long Enigma firing sequence each and every failure, so yeah, that took a while. But otherwise, this was fun, it was easy, it was laughable. I just love a good fast level. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you tune in next time. Until then, this is Kevvl, signing off. Ciao!